Hello everyone, welcome to this tutorial. Today, we're going to learn how to recreate this animated Instagram story using Linearity Move. Let's get started. When I first open the app, I'm going to see the home screen. To create a new document, I click the plus button. Here, I can pick the resolution of my new document or import an existing file. I can import a file from Curve, Linearity Design Tool, or connect to Figma and import a design from there. I'm going to select this Curve file and hit the Import button to enter the Scene Builder panel. Here, I can see as many artboards as there are on my design file. I tap and hold to drag one of the artboards to the Scene Builder line at the bottom of the panel. I do the same to add the second artboard and to create a second scene. When I am done, I click the Import button. I double tap on Scene 1 to start animating. I pinch the screen with my fingers to zoom in. I select the text layer. I open the preset panel on the right and I select the Masked Reveal preset. I move the playhead to second one and I apply the same preset to the second line of text. Here's my first transition. When I select a preset, keyframes appear automatically on the timeline and create a transition on my selected object. I move the playhead back to second zero and I activate the pin button. Pinning is a smart feature that helps me quickly define the start and end point of my next transition. With the playhead positioned at the beginning of the highlighted segment, I move the cursor to the bottom left corner outside the canvas. I can see that another keyframe is added automatically to the timeline to complete my transition. The cursor moves back to its starting point. I select the main graphic and I apply a new preset to it. This time, I pick the preset Elevate, which moves the object up and gives it a nice drop shadow effect. I select the animation bar and I slide it on the timeline. This way, the Elevate transition will start when the cursor goes over the main graphic. I bring the playhead back to the beginning of the timeline. I activate the multi-selection button and I select all the ovals on the background. Then I select the preset Scale In, which makes the ovals appear with a resizing effect. I tap and drag the animation bar for each of the ovals. This way, each transition will start one after the other for a more organic effect. I double tap on Scene 2. I select the multi-selection button and I select all the text layers. On the preset panel on the right, I select the From Right preset. This preset applies a position transition and an opacity transition to my text layers. They appear on the scene, moving in from the right side of the canvas. I select each animation bar and slide it along the timeline. This way, all the text layers are coming in from the side with a cascading effect. I select the star shapes and I apply a spin-in preset to them at once. I move the playhead to second 2 and I apply the spin-out preset. This way, each star is spinning in and, after a brief pause, it is spinning out of the scene. I slide the animation bar along the timeline, so each star animates in and out at slightly different times. With the playhead at the end of the scene, I now select the orange circles at the bottom right corner. I rotate the object using the orange dot on the bounding box. I press on the screen with my free finger to lock the rotation every 45 degrees. I do the same to rotate the circle in the top left corner. I click on the project button to go back to the scene view. Here, I select the lightning bolt icon between scene 1 and scene 2, and I use the panel on the right side to add a transition between the two scenes. I select the push type and set the direction to right to left. I change the timing to natural, and I increase the duration to 1.5 seconds. I double tap on scene 1 to add an additional transition. I activate the pin button and move the highlighted segment closer to the end of the scene. I move the playhead to the second pin and I reposition the cursor. I want it to touch the right side of the panel just before the scene transition happens. Now, it looks like the cursor is dragging an invisible curtain to change scene. I double tap on scene 2. I select and drag the animation bar at the top to delay the start of the animation. And with that, my animation is complete. When I'm ready, I can export my animation by clicking the down arrow on the top left corner of the screen. I select Export. Here, I can preview my animation one last time before exporting it. I select the best video format and the file codec for social media, and I select export. Thank you for joining me today. I hope you found this tutorial useful. You can learn more about Linearity Move and animation from the Learn tab on the home screen. Let's bring our stories to life with Linearity Move.